Hello, this is another episode of using crypto exchange data for our proof of concept bot. And this is our current situation, or current system. We have multiple exchanges with multiple currency pairs. And we have a scalable backend which uses Zookeeper for selecting the leader for a given exchange. We have a MongoDB, all asynchronous used, Kafka bus to connect the backend to the analysis module for simple arbitrage, and the frontend for presenting the arbitrage findings and the backend order books to the frontend, in fact, to the web browser. And this episode, we are going to look about scaling the frontend. This moment, the backend generate a lot of Kafka messages, so we like to have multiple frontends so we can process all the events from the backend and the analysis. So we have a look at the current code. We see that we store the opportunities and the order book in queues, and that we are listening for both the order books and the opportunities. So if you have multiple frontends, then certain messages are processed by this frontend and the other one, so for a given instance, it becomes impossible to have the latest state, because it will one frontend gets the half of the message and the other half are processed by the other one. So we have to share this state. And when you look what the possible solutions are, we can have a look at Zookeeper, but if you have a look what's going on in the business, then there are two alternatives being mentioned. Redis as a very fast database in memory or in store, or Hazelcast. And Hazelcast has in this case the advantage that it very easily maps for queues and other standard Java data types in a distributed fashion. So this time we will use Zookeeper for it. Hazelcast, I mean. And what will Hazelcast do? It will store the state from all different frontends. So, and then we have a distributed state, and then it will scale. So we will focus on making this state distributed. So let's create a new branch. Part 9, because we're already in part 9. And Hazelcast is a standard part of Spring Boot. And replace it with the Hazelcast Spring. Hazelcast Spring is standard Hazelcast with some Spring extensions. For instance, that the Hazelcast instance is being created and other useful beans. So therefore, we will use this one. And now we have a look what we want to replace. As we already knew from previous times, it is a queue, but in fact we only use the latest one. Only one, because when we say here opportunity, we clear them, and also in the order book, we clear them all. So in fact, there is room for one. And that's an other data type you can use for that. The atomic reference. So in fact, we want to have an atomic reference, and that's also a standard Hazelcast data type we can use for that. And the same is true for opportunities. However, we can't create it this way. We need a Hazelcast instance to create them. So we will add, we will make sure that the injection of auto wiring of Spring will be done in the constructor. Private final Hazelcast instance Hazelcast. Well, to keep them final, in fact, we have to make the constructor explicit instead of this implicit required function. So, we have a constructor being created. We will rename them to ref, because in the past it were a list or queues, but now they represent one reference to a order book and one to a opportunity. So we create an explicit constructor, and we want to create the order book ref and the opportunity ref via Hazelcast. And this is the way to do it. And we like to create a constant, because these names are very likely to be used in the configuration we will do at a later step. So we have to create those two constants. We don't need the Hazelcast, because we in fact only interested in this references, an object mapper we need. Okay, here we are. We also have to make sure that we have to replace all the code. This is also we don't need anymore, because we store only one order book and one opportunity in this reference. In fact, we want to store the combination of it, opportunities. That's better, because the opportunities is a list of opportunity. We have to get notice that the user interface still expects a list of opportunities, so we have to change it. We can remember it, but also can do it right now. And this is dot values. So, because, as you know, in shared, so instead of a list of opportunities, we give the opportunity, and it contains a list, and then the values, and then we have the same interface. Okay, so now it's the point to make the stuff working. In this approach, we do it message per message, then we get a lot of changes to the order book or also to the opportunities. But what we are in fact are doing is just pick the latest. So it's easier to replace this code in a streaming version. So we say messages.stream, and first we map the message from a string, because it's a string and we want to make a order book out of it. The difference between a streaming version and this one is that we do a lot of try catch. The whole reason of using a stream as well is to make it readable, and all those try catch thingies doesn't work. So we will create a helper function in the shared module for DTO functions. So, and it will DTO you. Yes, and this DTO utils will do a transformation between a given class to a string and the other way around. Okay, so we have a DTO util function. We have a from DTO. It transforms it from a string, and we know we have to define which type. It's in fact a wrapper around this object mapper. And we catch the exception here itself. We log it and we throw it, but now it's... We can use it in a streaming version. And the same for a 2 DTO. Well, we like to have the standard object mapper of the Spring Boot environment, because that one is capable of transforming data types and all kinds of things which are added via libraries to Spring Boot. So now we have the DTO util functionality. It's a wrapper function. Now we are capable of saying DTO, but first we have to create it, because the constructor needs a object mapper. So we say, well, we can probably replace it. We say, give me DTO utils. So instead of the object mapper, you say new pet name and the object mapper. So now we can use DTO utils. We have a string message and we want to go to the exchange audible class. So this is the first transformation. The next step is in fact a filter. We filter in here, is it the right exchange and the right currency pair? We do it via a filter. What's this? Filter. We have an order book and we, it's almost this if. And instead of exchange order book, we just call it order book. So is there, and the currency pair is the same. Yep. Okay, just to overcome all kinds of confusing things. So we have transformed it to a list of exchange order book. We filtered it, so at this moment we have a list of exchange order book and we like to have the latest one. Get latest, and that's a typical reduce function. Of course we can say if I have two values, A and B, Kafka sends them in an ordered way, so I pick the B, the latest one. So then this reduce makes sure that we have the latest of the list. Then, if there still is a value, because it could be filtered out, all of them, then we add, and for instance, the order book, because we are busy with order books. It's the order book. This is the way. And then we say the order book ref sets order book. However, if we do it this way, and now we can replace it in here, then we have to make sure that the exchange order book is serialized in a Hazelcast way. We will do that in the analysis probably, but now we can easier modify it to string because that's already supported out of the box with Hazelcast in the serialization. And we still want to send this a string or a JSON string to the web browser anyway, so there is no need at this stage to transform it or to keep it in an exchange order book form. So we say make it a string. So then I have to transform this, but we have this utility function. So this, it was a from and now it's a to DTO. And are we ready? Yeah. We probably missing one. So this is in fact the stream with just the same as in the old case. And we do the same for the opportunities. Same trick. But then of course instead of order book, I have to replace it by opportunity ref. And we have to do a different filtering, of course. But first, we start with opportunities, message. Now we have a different filter. we don't filter in here, but in fact we like to have, well, some information to be presented on the screen. So we say, well, opportunity, we only want to show opportunities with which are not empty. Then we continue. Reduce, it's the same. And now instead of the order book, we are going to say, the name, wrong one. We're still with this one. It's an opportunity. Opportunity ref. So we can say opportunity. We'll replace it in here. We have a look. What's here? Oh, same problem. It's a string. So now also the opportunities are handled in this. Okay, now send data. Well, it's not the right name for this method, in fact. It's in fact about what to do when the application is ready. We send order books and we send opportunities. And we first do this one. And then we do this because this is more text, but the trick will be the same. Every interval we send the opportunity ref. It's already a string. Get. And that's it. And it is only useful, of course, only to do it if it is a non-nil value. So replace it and we say if opportunity ref not nil, then we set it. That's it. And we, it's almost identical with what we have to do for the order book. So instead of order book, we do a order book, of course. It's not that identical. Order book ref instead of empty is nil. Then the message, we don't do this we don't do anymore. Message and the command we have to replace as well. So we get the message, pick the message. Well, it's not even useful. Tick. And now we send the message. We have the same in here. Message. No. This. And this on next, well, that was the queue useful for testing. Also a different type. Yep. String. Because this one is a string as well. Okay, so this process, this one, application ready. It's about sending order books and sending the opportunities, looking useful. And this is in fact almost identical to this, and also see that there is still a bug in it because, well, we have order books and we have opportunities, and when someone's connected, it only gets the order books, so we can send the opportunities as well. So this is in fact this order book, And we do ref concat, and we do the same for opportunity ref and different WebSocket. In fact, we have for all testing reasons also a show opportunity, so we can do that as well. So now if someone connects, it gets the order books and the show opportunities. So now we have transformed the exchange or the front end that we are capable of using Hazelcast and by creating them. Okay, but now there are still some issues because we are moving from one element to multiple elements. And where is my overview? I can draw some arrows. Because what can happen is this front end gets a number of messages, maybe a whole list. And then the next one is that the front end, this instance, get a small number of Kafka messages. For instance, a message with a lot of exchange order books from a different exchange. So it will update the state. And after that, this front end we had, all the data is replacing this state. So in fact, the ordering of Kafka, due to the fact that we have multiple front ends, because the example I gave was with two, but it can be two, three, or five, is that the ordering can be different. However, a given front end cannot detect if what the ordering is, because there is no ordering information in the messages. So if we want to overcome the problem of overwriting the state with all data, we have to introduce an ordering. So we say long order, and we assume that the backend and the analysis module will insert an order in these messages. We have them for a change order book and for the opportunities. So we go to the backend, where is it? Oh, it's in the service. So it's already start complaining, it likes to have a order number. Well, we want to have a thread safe object. Well, and Java has one, private final, it's called atomic long. Counter is new. So here, well, a counter can be get an increment as an atomic action. So then we are sure it's always incremented. But this exchange service is already scalable. So that means that if there are two, I want to refer to the previous episode, but it can handle, I didn't expect that arrow. No. It can handle the following case, that five exchanges are, for instance, connected to the backend, a new one is being added, then the exchanges are given to multiple backends. For instance, this gives two exchanges to handle, and the other one becomes the leader of the other three. So this number can be started again and again, and this take leadership is the natural moment to do it. It will call an init function, and the init function is then the way to say, well, counter dot set, give it a start value. For instance, start at 1. And the same is true for the analysis module. So you better copy it. And then we go to the backend, the frontend, and see what the consequences of this ordering is. It was the order service which create these opportunities. So counter, give it the value 1, because the analysis module is at this moment not scalable, means only one instance. So it's already being created, and in the backend we had this mechanism that we had to start all over again every time an exchange, when it becomes a leader of a given exchange. This opportunity builder order, and then the counter, and then we are sure that it is thread safe, and the reason that it is thread safe is that this message handler is asynchronous, so multiple handlings of this process order service can be done. So just to be we have to be sure that this, in fact, this method in multiple threads can use and update the counter. Okay, so now every opportunities message and every exchange order message has an order. Now we go back to the front end to use this information. So in fact, by saying set it, we in fact want to check if the order number of the belonging to this reference data is lower than the one to be updated. So in fact, we want to say, well, private final, and it has an atomic long as well. So order book counter. But you already see what we are doing here. I do this for this type, and I need it for this type as well. So we better can create a combined object which combines a reference and the counter. So then we can say the order book and opportunity are an instance of that type. So we want to create a class reference data which contains the reference and the counter which we just created, and the name for all kinds of logging purposes. We created, we already saw this line to tell Hazelcast that we how to create an atomic reference, and it's almost identical to create an atomic long. Same trick, is to distribute it. Hazelcast will make sure that it has distributed all over the network. And we create a separate function so that we are capable in tests, for instance, to reset the values. Clear, it's clear. And the counter, we already saw that we used 1 as a starting value, so -1 is for sure lower than all other counters we were given. So that also means that, so instead of create a reference data type, and we create a new, and we will use this name for the reference and the counter, and as long as are different types, that's no problem. And now we have a look why it is complaining. Oh, yeah, it's static, so I have to add the Hazelcast object as well. okay, because we use the same type, we can make a update function for updating the reference and the counter in one go. So we say void update. What we need is a reference data field. We need an order number. Order number, and we need, well, the new message, which is potentially be the reference, the new atomic reference field. So message. How will this function look like? We look at the counter. If it is smaller, then we replace the data, and else we are saying, well, we are out of sync. And let's have a go. Update. We need the order book. We need the... Oh, that's a confusing name. Now we need, of course, the order book ref. Then we need the order number. Get order and the message. The same in here. Update. Ref. Opportunity dot get order and so, well, that's a good start. However, there is a problem. We have to remind ourselves that it is a distributed system. So when I start comparing these values, that can mean that at the same time another instance is already starting to replacing the values. So after this if, it can be that in the meantime the data is already being replaced. So this set can then replace the newly updated data with old data or the other way around. So in fact we want to be sure that it is an atomic action, so that we are the only one comparing and setting the data. And Hazelcast has a semaphore, because we want to make it atomic via semaphore, a distributed semaphore as well. So not only a reference and a counter, but we also have to add a atomic what's the type? I semaphore. And so now we have a semaphore, then we can start using it. So first we say we want to acquire it. Dot semaphore dot acquire. Once we acquire it, we are sure that we are the only one at that moment changing the data, but also want to be sure that at the end it is being released. Release. So acquire, yep, it also yep, no, that is not the one I want to have. Because then it becomes part of the stream. I just want to say, I just want to catch the exception and you do log it, because that would mean that we are interrupting this acquire. It's not a real serious problem. But now we are sure that the data is being modified in an atomic way. So, So we compare it and if we are out of sync. There's only one problem we haven't addressed, and that's the problem about when backend are going to be added or replaced, because when one is added or replaced, these exchanges are being reshuffled in the number of backends that are there. So that would mean that the ordering number is different. For instance, we start at 1,000 and then suddenly this backend comes in, this exchange will be connected to this backend and it will start with the number 1, for instance. So this order number is for sure much lower. Well, we can try all kinds of tricks with special number and so on, but it would mean that we have to modify this filtering and this reduce, because we assume in fact that the next order number is higher than we already have. So it's probably easy in this case to say, well, if the difference is far higher than we would expect, then we have to start all over again by setting the message and setting the counter. We want to make a function if the difference is acceptable. So we say, well, what's the current version and what's the one we want to like to update? Well, if the current version is smaller than the update, then it's fine. And if the difference is larger than we would expect, then it is fine as well. And then this we make a configurable parameter. For instance here. And at this moment we say as a default 50. But we can, by this, we can change it. And now we have a way of saying this is fine. So we replace this comparison with a function. And then we are capable of handling backend changes and maybe in the future analysis module changes as well. Okay, so we are fine now. It's complaining in here. We are going to check if all the unit tests are still working, and if not, how to repair them. Yeah, we added an order number, so we just give it a 1. I mean, just give it a value. Once again. Now it's now started to compile. And it doesn't like them both. So what's the problem? Oh yeah, I've already know what I forgot. I did an assumption which is not correct, because when we create a semaphore, we have to tell Hazelcast what is the number of permits they're allowed to, what are the number of permits this semaphore has, and if you don't define, it's 0, so it will wait forever in this acquire. So we have to create a Hazelcast config class So here we can, this is the configuration, because it's Hazelcast Spring, we only have to tell Spring which configuration we want to use. And here we can see the reason we want to make a constant, then we can refer to it. And here we say the number of permits is 1. This is just to give it a name, and this is important what type of network we have, because this tells Hazelcast how to detect other instances. In my current computer doesn't like multicast configuration, so I disable it. And in fact, I say, all local host members can be joined. In the next episode, we'll have a look what the consequences of this front-end change are for the Docker, and we probably have to investigate how to get it working. But at this moment, this is good enough, and we check if this solves the problem. And if not, we have to look what the problem is to solve. And if we solve the problem, then the next step is to do a kind of smoke test to run the whole system via jars. This is fine and this is not fine. So the process now means it is working, and the non-matching, we have a look. It means we get a result and we didn't expect the result. Let's have a check if there is an influence between the tests. Because he saw that first this process where we expect a response is run, and after that the non-matching version is run. Okay, it's green, so it means these tests are influencing each other. And that's true because I don't clear the environment. I like to do a initialization. And this wants to do the init. In fact, it wants to call this init function of these two, the order book and the opportunity. So we say order book ref dot init and opportunity ref dot init. And now we clear these parameters, clear, and we set the counter to zero, especially this one. So then we are we can of course run the test, but that's very likely that was the causing the problems. I run them all. Last time the process went fine and the process non-matching didn't work. And now they're both green. Okay. So now we have the situation that the tests are working. We can run them now all because we made some modifications to the analysis module and the backend module as well. And then we are sure that it all compiles and so on and so on. Okay, so they're all successful now. And we are starting the backend. It's starting now. We're starting the front end. So this is in fact the first time we started with the new code. We can have a look how it. Okay, here, this is good news because it sees that Hazelcast sees the member, but at this moment there's only one, of course. And we start another front end, we would expect another member. But this gave problems in previous runs with the multicast enabled. So therefore I changed this to the other one. And it looks for this other ports. This is how it works. It's starting now. Looks as a problem still there. Gonna have a look how it looks like. Okay, so we are data is coming in. So there is some race condition in here, I have to look. But at this moment is not important. Because it's looking good now. We're going to start another front end. And what we do is we start the same application, but it will run on a different port. This is also something we have to solve in the Docker environment. Because in a Docker can only expose one port. And then you have to know as a web browser user which port to use that we have to solve. But for now, we just started. Now we have a look and I hope that it Hazelcast's multiple instances. Yes, it says this I am, but there is another member. And this is probably also the one which sees. Yes, the same in here. So both instances see that there is an other one available, but it also means that Hazelcast is working correctly. And it still runs. We can have a quick look in the counters, consumers. Well, both front end together are forming the front end group from a Kafka point of view. Counter is now 65,000, 83,000, so they are still behind. And hopefully they're chasing the one. And it is looking good because it's 71. So we have to wait. We better have to check if the analysis module is still starting. Oh, that's not the right button. And the analysis module is responsible for sending opportunity messages. The backend messages, so it's probably far behind. And now it's starting. Yeah, there it is. And here you see, so there is more than almost 150,000 messages behind. And as we know, where is the picture of the system? So this is in fact, we replace this. So this is also now capable of scaling. It's my own notation. This is Hazelcast, or cast. This is analysis not so, it's likely that we have a scaling problem there. And we don't see at this moment. Here it could also be, of course, that we have still a problem there. Well, I don't see any red things because we modified the application in there. In the past, we sent a list of opportunity, and now we send one opportunities data type. And we, of course, we want to be sure that it all works. I also probably have to make a modification in the logging, because in the past there was only one instance, so then we can log to a file, but we normally get a conflict. I'll have a quick look if there is logging. Yes, there is. Well, you can see that there is a number of messages, but we like to add data if there are opportunities being processed. Let's have a look if that's being logged. No, only out of sync. So what we can do is just dot peak, that at least we have info. It's only for debugging reasons, in fact. What was the message? Now we can mention the size of it, the number of records. Opportunity dot. Oh, the order number. So just to give it an ID if there is data coming in. Oh, we have a problem. We don't have to do this. Front end. This was also the one we are connected to, because front-end application 1 represented the port 8081. Now it sees the other, that's fine. And either it doesn't, we can have a look at the logging of the application or the analysis module. Well, it doesn't look good. We probably have to restart it. No. It doesn't like the objects. Some strange problem now. Data. It is. It's a problem in the serialization, strange. So what we can do is that we print the message that we received. What will we receive? Trash, not the right one. Debug. Then we can have a quick look what we are receiving. The strange thing is that the front end was capable of reading it, but here it isn't for unclear reasons. We also can use this DTO thingy. No, the data is now flowing in. It could be that there was still some old data in the queue. So there's another stability thingy that when maybe I changed the object and then we still haven't used an old Kafka version, set a kind of dead letter pattern. Not for now. And now we see data coming in. We make a connect to be sure. Then we see that the data is changing. So what it means is multiple front ends are handling this state and this state. We can have a look if out of sync messages are being processed. We still only have to solve this 0 versus 0 one. And we have, oh, strange in fact. Could also be all data. Because analysis had all data, here we have all data, it's recovering. And now we have in the situation that we are sending the stuff. Okay, so we have a look at our system. What do we have achieved? This was already there. SeaKeeper is already there, so nothing changed in there. The messages are having now a ordering number, so the front end can detect the ordering. And we are capable of creating multiple instances of the front end. And in the next episode, we will have a look what it means from the Docker perspective, because I from this moment already see two items. In Docker we say, okay, the frontend exposes one port, but when we start multiple frontends we have to do it in a different way, and we have to look if the detection of, where was it, in the Hazelcast, by saying multicast is false but do it in this way, will work in a Docker as well. But that's something for the next episode. If you have questions or remarks, please let me know down in the comments below. And see you next time when we move the front end from a jar to a Docker environment. Have a nice day.